Okay. Gonna be making a lily today. Gonna use the cadmium with a veil of turbo cobalt over it as the main body of the flower. Then experimental green over white for the leaves. And probably white for the dots, the pistils and the stamen. I'm gonna do a gather, and I'm kinda gonna let it bunch up, not really just melt it from the top, because I don't want that clear to wrap over itself, because it can create kind of a distortion line. So I just kinda slowly let it bunch and gather together. This is also a good chance for you to clean up the glass, if there's any dot specks on it. I want to keep this top part of this clean because that's going to be the bottom of Maria when I flatten it out. Normally I use a little bit thicker rod and use a shorter piece. But this will work. The demo. So once this gather gets, you know, I want about an inch of that neck still, that thick neck in there. I'm just going to gather it down to about 1 inch of thick neck. Thank you. Most important thing is you got a nice smooth transition between the neck and that gather. So when you flatten it out, you get a nice Maria, nice transition with the neck into the Maria. I always pull a center point, and I want to remove glass, not add glass, and it's just a reference point. I'm going to go to a nice soft flame when I lay down the design. The first set of petals is going to be a series of basically three V-shaped petals. You'll notice I always clean the tip and I always clean the end point. Shaking a little bit. The water. stringer just broke. So that's the first layer. Now I'm going to get those embedded. I'm going to start to tool these lines. They're not quite embedded. A little bit of a bubble right there. I'm going to go back and push up the point because I want that point of each of these petals a little bit higher. Actually, they might be. Nope. Almost forgot the white dots in the center. Oops. I'm doing very good with these dots. So that's the first layer of petals. Now I'm going to wrap this glass around, get them embedded, or get them kind of raised up in the glass before I do my second layer. Get that to concave, pattern starts to condense, compress. I want to kind of bring that design kind of flush to the surface before I do anything else. So, second set of lines, petals. I'm going to go a little bit more. It's not quite condensed enough for my liking. So one more concave, condense, compress. That looks a little better. Wrong spot. Cheering for the wrong spot. So I was just able to remove a little bit of that residual glass once I popped that line off. Let's see if we can get this one in the right place. Ah. So that's it with the pedals. I'm going to bring this, once I get them tooled, I'm going to bring it all the way down to a termination point, put in a stem, and then I'll put in the leaves. You want to get these embedded. Sacred geometry. So I'm going to tool them just like I did the first layer. Give them a series of creases. One on top, two on either side. Push that top one because I want it a little bit further up, so I make sure and go back, give that top one a little bit extra push with the pick. So that's the lily. I'm going to bring it all down to a point. Start to see that start to concave, that's when I start playing with the balance or the angle towards gravity. Really want it to move, lift up the back end. Don't want it to move so much, go a little bit more parallel towards gravity. But I'm concentrating right on the hip of that Maria because I want that design to condense, just to kind of pinch it. Pinch it. And before it gets too drastic, check it on the graphite. See it start to get smaller. The Maria will start to get bigger now, because I don't want to just keep flattening it. Because I want the integrity of that flower to still come up. If I, spend too much time flattening it, your neck coming down into that Maria is going to force all your petals out towards the equator. So you slowly want to let this start to grow as you get towards the end of your flower. See, I'm barely pushing. It's almost its own weight that's pushing it down. You're working with colors that are a little bit stiffer. It's really easy to get that concave a little bit too deep where you can't get it, so you gotta be mindful of that. Now I'm going to start to terminate this point. There was a mic there. I always wanted to be a drummer in a rock and roll band, so that's why. Not really. Drummers are the crazy ones. Looks like I got a good termination on that. We'll see once I get it in the flame, and I'm going to remove a little bit more. Now the stem and a pair of leaves. want to get those leaves embedded, and then I'm going to push them with the pick, give them a point. Give the stem a little push and then the leaves a little push. We got a little bit of bubbles on that green, but oh well. It's a demo, right, Roy? It's a demo, right? That was two. Yeah, be careful, it's starting to get a little deep. Might have to go and grab that stem. We're definitely gonna have to go in and grab that. This is what I call the knuckle burner. I have my torch at home pivoted so I can move this without contorting my bodies quite so much. That should be everything. My water is broken. Trying to bring a little bit more glass down around these leaves so they're a little bit more pronounced. Now I'll start my punties. Fire cut the handle. Cleaning up some of the crap on the glass. Kind of prehistoric looking. So two more punties. Went a little quick. It always works best if you got that punty nice and centered and flush to the connection point. So one more punty right on the bottom, and that should do her. Good enough for a demo. I always like a nice, fresh kind of punty. That way I can do a real light contact, strong light contact. I usually like to go a little bit off center from where that stem is. Sometimes right where that stem is, if you punny up to it, it kind of leaves a stubborn punny mark. So there's the lily. Last punty is usually straight up, then I point the torch down. It's good from that angle. Voilà.